People who don't ever want to have kids. Why? It's expensive and I don't wanna pass on my genes in particular. The gene thing in particular hits me hard. I have an incurable autoimmune disease. And there's at least a 20% chance I pass the disease I have on to my children. And not to mention the possibility of an even more severe autoimmune disease like lupus. I don't think I'd ever be able to forgive myself if I passed that on to a child. Especially with how much I struggle with my own disease. It's one of the issues that bothers me most about whether I want to have kids or not. Kids, in this economy. No, I'll just settle for my cat. Cat, in this economy. No, I'll settle for my pet rock. I just have no desire. I don't hate kids. I love my nieces and nephews and have a great time being an influential part of their life. However, that means that I also see how difficult and stressful it is to raise kids. I understand that people really love it and it's worth it to them. But that's just not me. I love my niece and nephew too, but after an entire day with them I really, really need some peace and quiet. If it's your own kids, you don't get that. So I imagine that, but 24/7, and I don't understand how people do it. Money. Because I believe that children deserve parents that will love them, always put them first, spends quality time with them, and make sacrifices so that their children can have the best opportunities, but at the same time, have the strength to set boundaries and discipline them in a healthy, so they grow into good human beings. Also because I don't currently have a partner or much financial stability in my life at this stage and I don't want to be a single parent or bring a child into the world if I'm not in a position to provide for them. And I don't trust myself to be unselfish enough to be everything that I believe a child deserves. I sometimes catch myself thinking that children might be nice, but until I'm sure of myself, financially stable and in a steady relationship, a child is unlikely to be in the picture. And I don't trust myself to be unselfish enough to be everything that I believe a child deserves. Same. In psych class we learned about a study where they separated monkeys from their mothers at birth. The monkeys grew to be anxious and twitchy. When those monkeys had their own kids, the mothers didn't know how to care for them. I was raised horribly, so I don't know how to raise someone well. My parents had children, even though their parents abused them. My grandparents' parents probably also abused them. I'm just cutting off the cycle. You know how people often say I'll do a better job than my parents ever did? Yeah. That doesn't always work out that way. My parents were absolutely horrible to us. My sibling said I'll do a better job. She really thought she would. She didn't. She didn't finish her education. Just like our parents didn't. She's completely overwhelmed with taking care of her children. Just like our parents were. Her husband is trash. Just like our father was. She has untreated mental issues. Just like our mother had. Her children are unruly. Constantly fight. Have zero manners. She didn't do a better job. I did get help for my issues. And I can safely say that I will not be a better parent. The one thing I can do is take in teens as a foster parent. So I can help them with school, going to university, and getting the proper help. Because if I can do it, so can they. Teens deserve help. I don't need to put children on this planet if there are plenty for me to help. I wish someone had helped me when I was a teenager. I also want to foster instead of have a baby. When I think about having a child, it freaks me out. But when I think of adoption fostering, it makes me happy inside. I feel like I would be a terrible mother for a baby or toddler, but can be a good parent for teens. Freedom. My husband and I would probably be pretty good parents and we're in a good spot financially, but we feel complete with each other. We have fun together and want to spend the rest of our lives without the responsibility and stress of kids. Pretty much exactly the same for my wife and I. Life is good. Life is simple. Let's keep it that way. Lack of desire to become a parent or have kids. You know how some people want kids so bad. They suffer mentally and emotionally from not having them, or knowing they can't have them. How people say they feel hormonal. Wanting kids real bad. They can't control it. Their ovaries are exploding. Baby fever. Or any other colloquialism about wanting to have a baby real soon. Never had that. People kept telling me that as I'd grow older. would reach my 30s, find my soulmate, my friends start having children, etc. I would start to have that feeling. I went through all these milestones, and I still had it, don't have that desire for kids. And I don't think it's necessary to have kids, if one does not have the desire for it. Same. It feels so weird to be asked why I don't want kids, because the answer is as simple: I just don't want them. No deep dark secrets or anything like that. Just like I didn't want to major in accounting or learn to play the violin. There's nothing wrong with it. I simply have no interest for myself. If anything, it's people who want, decide to or have kids who should be asked why. They're the ones undertaking a huge life change and serious responsibilities and imposing their choice on someone who didn't ask anything. Edit preemptively. I don't need replies from people who need to tell me why they had kids. I don't care. It's not my business. I'm just saying that as far as small talk or discussions about reproductive choices go, people doing something are a better topic than people who are not doing something. Like, no one is going to ask me why are you not climbing the Everest? Why didn't you become an astronaut? I lack the drive. I don't want to give birth and go through all that. Adoption is a long process and a lot of money that I don't have kids are expensive. As someone who wants to become an elementary school teacher, people are often shocked to find out I don't want children. But the reason is simple: they cost a lot of money. They take up a lot of free time and space, and I have terrible genes. I'm actually considering becoming a teacher too, and I also don't want kids. I love science and I like to explain things about ecology or biology, so teaching is like a free captive audience. JK JK, I had a really shitty science teacher and a really shit school, and I want to offer something better to kids. My parents were kind of neglectful, and I got bullied a lot, so I feel like I would be a teacher that could show them empathy they wouldn't normally get. I feel like I'm too poor to have my own, and I worry about not being a good parent, and also losing my freedom. But kids that go away at the end of the day might not be so bad. I'm a child-free high school biology and chemistry teacher. When I first started teaching, I was kinda on the fence about having kids. I just finished my 9th year teaching and I love my job, but I'm now 100% certain I don't want my own kids. I love my students, and you're right. Having a free captive audience while I nerd out about some topic is awesome, but I couldn't stand coming home and spending the rest of my limited time with even more children. It's convinced me enough I'm going to get snipped next month. I'm lazy. I like my free time. I like money well. The little I have, I like sleep. I've also just never had the instinct in me to want kids. I feel complete without them. Plus, it's scary enough worrying about my own future, let alone the future of miniature humans I'm responsible for bringing into the world. Rather give it a miss. This is exactly it for me. I take care of what needs to be done. I have a good job. I have great people in my life. But I'm selfish with my free time. I need time to myself, and I'm not willing to sacrifice that for kids. I don't even dislike them. I have plenty of great kids in my life that I watched grow up, and I truly love and enjoy them. I just don't have any desire whatsoever to be the one responsible for taking care of them. They're a massive financial and emotional responsibility. Emotional responsibility. Yeah. I'd make a horrible father. I don't see that changing in the next 20 years. Try telling that to my fam. I feel like a lot of parents have kids for the grandkids. Yup, my mother-in-law keeps telling us she wants us to have kids. Yet, we have no desire to have children. My brother-in-law had a kid with his wife just to make his mom happy. He didn't want kids either, and he is broke as a joke. Feel bad for him. Never have kids just for the grandparents. I have kids and never wanted kids. If you don't want kids, please don't have kids. I don't know how to quote, but when you said, "If you don't want kids, please don't have kids," all I ever wanted was to be a mom. My whole life. And I finally had my daughter 2 years ago. It can be hard. And this was something I desperately wanted. For over 30 years. I love my kid more than anything in the entire world. And would die for her. But it's still ducking hard. So if people aren't sure, or are on the fence, just don't. I want to do what I want, when I want. Yeah, kids are the opposite of that. I know a few parents who did what they want, when they wanted despite having kids. Sure didn't help kids, but the parents seemed content. I was parentified as child to my four younger siblings. When I see a child now, I act nice, but cannot wait to get away from it. A child crying, screaming immediately puts me in a angry, foul mood for the rest of the day. I had my share of caring for kids, and have next to nothing positive come out of it. Yeah, I'm with this. My two younger half brothers are 10 and 13 years younger than me, and I have a sister 3 years older. My sister and I basically raised my little brothers because our mum was working a lot of nights and weekends and their father was always playing video games while we fed them and bathed them and all that stuff. As an added bonus, one of my brothers had type 1 diabetes from the age of 3, so we would regularly look after his blood sugar levels and give him insulin injections. We were still teenagers at the time too. Now I have no interest in having kids, because I already know all the work involved, and I've done it before. And my partner isn't interested in kids either. We would rather save our money and travel the world. Can't even take care of myself. For me, it's the myriad of mental disorders I have. I don't want to pass that on to another human being, much less my own child. You both sound like you'd still make way better parents than the people who will never consider their children, even when they are physically here at all. I tip my hat to you both. Edit for making such a thought out and responsible choice to not have kids. Edit to I have many people in my family who have made the same choice due to mental health and physical health reasons, and I could not admire and respect them more. It's a constant battle, and I also would not wish anyone's life to be that hard if avoidable. That's the sad truth of it, isn't it? I have the same reasoning for not wanting kids. And when I try to explain this to my friends that have children, I often get the "you'll never be ready." I wasn't ready, but when we were surprised with children, we figured it out. You'll figure out a way to make it work once you have them. That is not advice I'm comfortable with. Edit, most of you who are defending the never prepared sentiment are entirely missing my point. A lot of you are talking about how the birth of your child has affected you, not the child. I'm concerned with the opportunities I can afford the child. That is what really worries me. I hope more people really think about it and feel ready for children before they decide to bring someone to this really difficult existence. I was not so lucky. That is not advice I'm comfortable with. It's funny how the people who insisted that I must change my mind about not having kids and that if I got surprised, I'd end up being happier than ever before were the same people who seemed utterly miserable in their lives as parents. I will let you know after my 10-hour nap when I get to the pub. As a parent of two young kids, this is the answer. Not necessarily pub, but just basically being able to do whatever the duck, whenever the duck is glorious. I absolutely love my kids and they enrich my life in a lot of ways, but you sacrifice a lot. For some people, the trade-off is worth it, for others, it's not. All respect in the world to people who understand themselves well enough to know that it's a sacrifice they don't want to make. It's okay to just enjoy your life. Also, the option to do nothing. I miss doing nothing for hours at a time. Now that my daughter is old enough to take care of herself, 16, I find that I appreciate my do nothing time way more than I used to. I find them very annoying. All of the parents I know keep asking, when are you having kids? It's so great. Yeah. You look like you're having a blast at life with those giant bags under your eyes, like you're barely clinging to your sanity as your kid screeches in the background. Parents feel obligated to say that because they don't want their kids to feel like a burden or a regret. Thanks to the anonymity of the internet, parents have more ability to be honest, and some of them do regret having kids. I value my mental health. I personally don't want to put my body through the trauma of growing and birthing a child. Children, I can barely emotionally handle myself a lot of the time, and don't want to risk passing on any of my mental illnesses to someone who didn't ask to be born. And they are overall a huge financial burden, and with the pandemic having destroyed my personal finances, I will never be in a financial position to feel comfortable raising a child. I don't even know if I will have a future myself. It feels selfish to bring a child into this world at this current state. I hate the sound of kids screaming and crying. Like, it doesn't scare me, it's annoying. Money, and I'd make a shitty father. My freedom. I thoroughly enjoy being able to travel on a whim and not have to worry about a money-less dependent tagging along, or being able to go out for dinner or just skip it if I'm not hungry, rather than having to worry about someone else and what they want to eat, or having a car with no back seats and not having to deal with a car seat. I like being responsible for myself and just myself. My life is complete without children. Plus, I'd rather just stick to cats. Imagine how much money I can save. Woo. So many reasons. One, I like my life how it is right now. Sleeping in. Taking spontaneous trips. Spending my money on myself. Having a kid means your entire life changes. And I don't want my life to change. Two, I don't want the responsibility. C1. 3, I think that global warming and other factors mean the world won't be nice for too much longer. I don't want to force someone to live through that. 4, I don't like children for extended periods of time. I like kids and find them sweet and funny, but they are exhausting over long periods. 5, this is petty, but as a woman, I don't want the body changes that come with having a baby. The question should be, people who want to have kids, why?